Hello, friends. Welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and hope you're all having a great time. Huge news, fresh from Starbase. On July 28th, 2023, at 1:09:56 p.m. Central Daylight Time, SpaceX conducted an impressive and successful full-pressure water deluge test. The purpose of this test was to examine the effectiveness of the flame deflector system, and it yielded remarkable results. The event was quite a sight as thousands of gallons of water were sprayed from newly installed metal plates. These plates are meant to help mitigate the impact of the engine's heat and power during IFT2. Prior to the first full water deluge test, the chopsticks were moved up. A significant announcement was made instructing everyone to clear the pad for deflector testing. Once the alert was heard, the pad was mostly cleared, with only a few workers remaining. Booster 9 was resting on the pad during this test. The full-pressure test of the new Starship flame deflector lasted for approximately 20 seconds. Interestingly, keen observers might have noticed that the splash pad did not spray water up B9's skirt. This was likely done intentionally to avoid any potential damage to the engines. SpaceX previously revealed through its Twitter handle that on Friday, they were all set to conduct a full-pressure test of the highly anticipated new Starship flame deflector, or to put it simply, it's an OLM steel plate water deluge system pressure test. A flame deflector, as you may know, is a critical component positioned beneath a launch pad. Its primary function is to ingeniously divert the intense exhaust produced by the rocket to the side during liftoff. This is no small feat, as the force unleashed by these mighty rockets is nothing short of awe-inspiring. To mitigate the risks associated with this incredible energy, SpaceX wisely employs a flame deflector bucket complemented by a water deluge system. Together, these tried and tested technologies work in harmony to neutralize the potentially hazardous effect of rocket exhaust. SpaceX has been working diligently on developing and perfecting this deflector, even at the time of the Starship launch. Interestingly, back in October 2020, Elon Musk set an ambitious goal of launching in Texas without a flame deflector. It was a daring notion, and he candidly acknowledged that it could turn out to be a mistake. As the results of the test flights seem to indicate, it indeed was an unfeasible endeavor. Nonetheless, there's a rationale behind this audacious attempt. SpaceX has its sights set on transforming heavy lift launches into a routine, almost commonplace operation akin to airline flights. To achieve this extraordinary ambition, streamlining launch pad operations becomes paramount. By eliminating complex deflectors and water deluge systems, SpaceX can substantially reduce costs while paving the way for a more accessible future in space exploration. But now SpaceX successfully completes the test of the new water-cooled steel plates. Moreover, this pursuit of simplicity holds a profound significance when we consider long-term goals such as launching from distant celestial bodies like the Moon or Mars. A straightforward pad, or perhaps even no pad at all, symbolizing the triumph of human ingenuity over the challenges of space travel. The next step for B9 is a spin prime and static fire, which will also evaluate the performance of the new splash pad under the OLM. However, there are currently no scheduled road closures for this upcoming test. Now, here comes a moment that calls for a touch of emotion, for it's time to bid farewell to a pioneer of the skies, SN15, a vessel that captured the hearts of many and etched its name in the annals of space exploration. With both a sense of pride and sadness, we must acknowledge that SN15's journey has come to an end. SN15, the trailblazing Starship prototype, has undeniably left an indelible mark in the history of spaceflight. It was the first of its kind to achieve a high-altitude suborbital test flight successfully. However, as with all things, the time has come for this remarkable vessel to find its final rest. It's with a heavy heart that we must acknowledge that SN15's days of soaring through the skies are behind it. Yet, in the same breath, we celebrate its accomplishments and the valuable insights gained through its flights, which will undoubtedly shape the future of space exploration. As we look to the horizon, the fate of Ship 26 now lies in the hands of the wise and judicious Council. As the excitement builds up at Starbase, the final water tank is now making its way to its destination. This water tank is indeed quite big, but when we put it into perspective, it's just a small piece of the puzzle compared to what lies ahead. In the forthcoming months, the real stars of the show will be the massive cryogenic storage tanks that are scheduled for transportation. These cryogenic storage tanks will be on a whole new scale of magnitude, dwarfing the size of the current water tank. We're talking about colossal loads that will break records and surpass anything we've witnessed being delivered to this site before. As we eagerly anticipate their arrival, it's worth noting that handling such enormous tanks will undoubtedly pose some extraordinary challenges. The logistics, engineering, and teamwork required will be on an unprecedented level. However, the team at Starbase is well prepared and up for the task. With each new delivery, the Starbase project takes another step closer to its ambitious goals. As the site expands and prepares to accommodate these gigantic tanks, we can't help but marvel at the magnitude of human ingenuity and the sheer scale of this endeavor. On the other hand, a remarkable achievement for Booster 9. It appears that the recent cryogenic proof test was a success. On July 23rd, the closure came into effect, and during the test, frost was visible on both of Booster 9's tanks. This was the very first cryogenic test since its inaugural launch, making it an impressive sight to behold. It seems that Booster 9 was either fully loaded or was very close to being fully loaded with cryogenics. Now let's look at some other SpaceX news. And you'll be happy to know that SpaceX is raising $750 million in funding, valuing the company at $137 billion. The funding will support the Starship program, aimed at sending the first manned mission to Mars. Recent events have affected Musk's reputation, including controversies surrounding his takeover of Twitter, accusations of censorship, and concerns about dividing his attention across multiple companies. Despite these challenges, the new funding for SpaceX is a positive development. Investors like Andreessen Horowitz are participating in the funding round, which slightly lowers the previous valuation of up to $150 billion. SpaceX has already raised significant funds through equity financing and boasts notable investors like Alphabet and Fidelity Instruments. The company's partnership with NASA and its internet satellite project, Starlink, add to its revenue prospects. With its bold goals, innovative approach, and collaborations with organizations like NASA, SpaceX is poised to shape the future of space exploration. Despite the competition, the company continues to secure funding and make significant strides towards its vision of becoming a pivotal player in the space industry. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.